Hi, my name is Jessica Burke, and I am the AT Center Coordinator here at the PALG program at Curry College. Today I want to teach you about a great website that I found that can help you with citations in your papers. That website is called MyBib.com, and unlike other citation generators, it is 100% free, which means that you can actually use all of its features immediately, which is pretty cool. To get started, you're going to need to make an account. If you go here on the homepage, you can choose to sign in with your Google account, or you can create an account using an email address and creating a password. As you can see here, I use the AT Center email address to make my account. Once you log into your account, you're going to come to a page that looks a lot like this. And as you can tell, there's not a project here. So what we're going to do is we're going to start a new project. To do that, you are going to go up into the left-hand corner to this button that says start new project, and a new project will pop up. You have the option right away to change the name of that project. So for the purposes of this video, I am going to name mine research project. So the nice thing about MyBib.com is that it gives you the opportunity to make a works cited or a reference page, no matter what citation style that your professor requires. So for example, if you had a professor that wanted you to do a works cited page in MLA format, MyBib.com is able to do that with no problem. So in order for you to make sure that your project is in MLA format, what you would do is you would go up into this middle button right here, click on it, and as you can see, it gives you all of the major and more popular citation styles, but also a wide range of other ones as well. But for the purposes of this video, we're going to go back to change it to MLA. So I'm going to scroll down, find MLA format, hit save, and then from here on out, the remainder of our Works Cited page will definitely be in MLA format. So now here comes the fun part, which is citing sources. MyBib.com makes it really easy for you to cite anything as simple as a website, a book, a peer-reviewed journal, or really anything that you might need for any of your school assignments. And there's two ways that you can do it right here on the website. The first is if you go right up into the upper left-hand corner over here, you can hit that green button that says Add Citation, or right in the workspace, there's also that same green button where you can hit Add Citation. Either way, you're going to use the same button, and it's going to open up to the same spot. So when you get to this place, it shows you some options. You can either do a website, a book, a journal, a video, or if there's something else that you're looking for, you can also click this More button and it will give you a lot of other options for you to pick from in order to find the perfect thing to use for your citation. So let's just keep it simple for now and let's cite a website. So let's say that I was doing a homework assignment and I found this really great article on CNN.com that I think would be great for my assignment. I'm going to go to the actual CNN website. I'm going to highlight the URL, copy it, and then paste it right back into the website search function. And if I did everything correctly, that exact website is going to show up immediately on the website, which is pretty cool. So once I know that this is the right website, I am going to click on it, and then it's going to bring me up to a secondary page. And this is where it's going to ask you to double check the information that's automatically generated. So things like the author, the title of the article, the date it was published, and the URL. And then it might ask you also to enter in the date accessed, which means the day that you actually looked at the website. For me, it's today, so I'm just going to add today. Once you think all of the information looks good, you can hit save, and just like that, you have a citation already made, and it's in the proper format, and you don't need to worry about anything like indentations or anything like that. All right, so let's do it again, and this time let's do it with a book. And books can be a little bit more challenging, especially if you don't have the physical textbook or book right in front of you, and this is kind of what I mean. So if we click on Add Citation and we go to the Book tab, and let's say we use the book The Handmaid's Tale. So we'll type in The Handmaid's Tale and hit search, and as you can see, there's a bunch of different results here. So it's really important that you know exactly which edition and the ISBN number so you know that you're using the proper book in your citation. So for the purposes of this video, I'm going to say, oh, that ISBN number is correct. I'm going to click on this version of The Handmaid's Tale. I'm going to then go to this site again, or this part of the page again, and I'm going to double check that the author's okay, that the title's okay, the publishing date is fine, the publisher, and any other information that I might need to add, ensure that it looks good, hit save, and then again, I have another citation generated. And as you notice, this one went actually above our first citation because it will automatically put your citations in alphabetical order by author, which I thought was pretty cool. So once you've felt like you've used all of your sources or you've added everything that you think you need for your project, now you can actually download it or save it to your computer or even print it. MyBib makes it really easy for you to save it in a variety of different formats, including a Word document, a Google Drive format, or even just simply printing it right from the website. So to do that, we're going to go right up into the top right-hand corner, which is that blue button right there, and you're going to click on it. As you can see, it shows you all the different formats that you can download it or print it out in. So you could copy and paste it into a Word document. You can simply download it as a Word document, upload it to your Google Drive, email it to yourself, and even print it or get a share link. There are other formats there too that aren't as common, but those are other ones that you can use as well. So if I want to save it to a Word document, I click on it and you get a little surprise, and then you save it to your file and then you're all set. You have a great Works Cited page that you can use for future assignments. So before we end this video, I wanted to show you two more pretty interesting features of MyBib.com that I think would be helpful for you while you're working on any sort of assignment here at Curry. And the first being the in-text citation function, which means that if you're working on a paper and you need to cite your source within that paper, they can actually generate that for you as well. So the easiest way to do that is to go right up to one of your citations, click that little box over on the left-hand side, and then as that menu drops down, you're going to hit the quote button, click on it, and then pull up your paper and paste that citation right into it. So you have no doubts whatsoever if your citation, in-text citations are correct. And then one last interesting feature of MyBib.com is the ability to share your stuff with others. So if you hit share right here, you can enable it, and you can do that in two ways. You can either send a share link or directly email your Works Cited to somebody, which is really helpful when you're working on a group project and you need to keep all of your citations in one place. And that's about it. MyBib is a really great tool to have in your technology toolbox, so I absolutely encourage you guys to try and use it as often as you can. If you still need some support with how to use this website or have any other questions about some tips and tricks, please do not hesitate to come down to the AT Center and we can help you out with whatever you need. Thanks so much for watching!